Hey, what's up there, everybody? This is Thavius Beck, and in the following video, I want to show you a new device in Bitwig 2 that's called Amp. This device does guitar amp modeling, so if you're a guitar player and you want to get a native device in your DAW that can help you really shape your sounds, this is a great tool to use. But of course, we can always use it in ways that aren't necessarily intended, and that's what I'm going to go for in this little video. So let me turn my attention towards Bitwig over here, and I've got a little beat that I've been working on, and I have the Amp device on a synth sound that's doing a little melody, and I also have this on my drums group, and I'm going to process all of my drums with it. But first, let me just play what's going on here without any amp audible. Right now, the mix is all the way down on this particular track. So the first sound I'm going to work with is this sound here, the synth pluck sound. And as we can see, here is my amp device. Now it's activated, but the mix is all the way down. So we're just hearing the dry signal. We're not hearing any of the effect from amp. Now we see that we have the pre and the post EQ. So we can basically shape the frequencies before amp gets applied and then also shape the output as well. We have different amp types here that we can choose from. And we have the drive amount here. Now I've chosen a setting that I like quite a bit, but let me just start from the beginning. Let me play this again. And I'm going to bring this in so it's completely wet. So right now we're hearing the smooth character here. A decent amount of drive has been applied here. I shaped this so I can get rid of some of the lows and kind of boost a bit of the highs. Well, boost a bit of the mid-range here before amp gets applied. And again, just deactivate this. And activate it again. Now the amp model that I chose was this one down here called Pixelated. I like this because it just sounds very aggressive and kind of broken up. Quite nice. We can play with the bias here. We can sound a bit more like a busted amp. And I like that quite a bit. All right, sounds pretty good there. Once we choose the amp model that we like, and we apply the amount of necessary drive, over here we have a cabinet section, and we can send the output of the amp through this cabinet, and we can change the dimensions of the cabinet here to affect the sound, and we also have different cabinet types to choose from. In my experience, cabinet type C and G seem to preserve the most amount of bass without introducing any sort of kind of odd phasing, which in this particular sound I don't really want. However, if you do get any sort of weird phasing going on, you can always invert the phase by hitting this button here. And we can blend this in as much or as little as we want. So without the cabinet, with the cabinet completely wet, so let me unsolo this so we can hear the new sound with the beat. And I'll do some parallel processing here so it's not completely amped out the game. So before amp, after amp, I like it. So that's one application there. Now another application, like I said, would be applying this to some drums. So let me solo my drum group here. I've deactivated amp. And that's how our drum sound before any effect is applied. Let me go ahead and enable this. And again, I've kind of already kind of set this to my liking. I'm using the Fold B preset here. In this case, I've boosted some of the lows so that we can get a bit more bass affected by the amp effect. I'm gonna go ahead and turn up the mix amount now. So very, very different sound. I like that quite a bit. This could also be a good candidate for some parallel processing. But one of the other things that I did here is that we can put an effect in to affect the audio before amp is applied and after amp is applied. And in the pre area here, I've actually added a delay. Right now, this is not active. Let me go ahead and activate this. And now I can blend that with the unaffected signal. So anyway, amp is a great tool, a great sound sculpting tool, a way to shape your sounds in some different ways. So whether you're a guitar player or not, I think there's plenty of good stuff to get out of this brand new device. So have fun applying this to your sounds and get nice and dirty and gritty with it.